Sheila Lockwood vividly remembers the last time she saw her 23-year-old son, Austin, in June of 2018.
Austin left my house, gave me a hug. I told him to be safe, and I loved him. And he went to work.
After work, he left his home state of Illinois and went to help a friend fix up a cabin in northern Wisconsin. They went to a bar.
The maximum speed limit on the road in its entirety, I think, might be 45. And that's fast. He was going over 70 miles an hour and lost control and crushed my son against a tree.
Austin was the passenger, his friend, the driver. After that, Lockwood became an advocate and started working with Mothers Against Drunk Driving, or MADD. In November, President Joe Biden signed the infrastructure bill into law that will require automakers install technology that makes it nearly impossible to drive drunk.
It will not only save lives, but it will protect those that, you know, maybe make a bad decision and get behind the wheel when they shouldn't.
But how will it work? We asked a professor in the software engineering program at the Milwaukee School of Engineering. He used to be in the auto industry.
The technology, the usage of the technology is new, but the technology itself is not new.
What are some of the ideas, the preliminary ideas?
So the initial ideas, one of them is some sort of a sensor that would either be embedded in the start button or on the steering wheel. And what it would do is shine an infrared light into your finger and basically look for the telltale signs of alcohol inside of the blood. Other systems that are being talked about would potentially look at exhaled breath and measuring alcohol content basically in the air. And other systems that are down the road would look at basically camera photos of the driver as they're driving to see what is whether they have signs of being impaired.
There are still a lot of questions. When we reached out to the Wisconsin Department of Transportation, they sent me a statement from the Bureau of Transportation Safety saying, in part, states are still waiting to learn more about how they will be impacted, including any potential funding changes to impaired driving programs or new requirements. Even with questions, this mother says it's a big win.
What do you think, Austin would say?
He would probably have a really big grin on his face and say, that's sweet, Mom, you know, way to go.
Thanks to Sheila for sharing her story with us. Now, according to the legislation, the anti-drunk driving system could be in cars in 2026. Wisconsin is the only state where a driver's first OWI is a civil violation.